Deputy Gerry Adams.
Taoiseach, I want to raise with you an issue today that I raised with you previously in private. And you will recall before the summer recess that I gave you a file about the tragic death of Shane O'Farrell as a result of a hit-and-run incident in County Monaghan in August 2011. And Shane's mother, Lucia, she's here with us today in the public gallery, Taoiseach. The O'Farrell family believe, and his mother believes, that their son's death was preventable, but there were multiple failings by and Garda Síochána before Shane's death, after Shane's death, and they questioned decisions made by the DPP. And they believe that a statutory investigation is the only way that their questions will be answered. And there does appear, Taoiseach, I'm sure you've read the file, there does appear to be serious irregularities in the interactions by some Gardaí with the accused. The man in question was known to Interpol, had 42 prior convictions, including drug offences, theft, road traffic offences, malicious damage and handling stolen property. At the time he killed Shane, he was on bail from Cavan Circuit Court, Monaghan Circuit Court, Dundalk Circuit Court and Newry Court. He continuously breached his bail conditions and re-offended. Shockingly, 2 weeks before Shane's death, Garda were notified of this man's arrest in the north by the PSNI in breach of his bail conditions, but the Garda failed to take action and obtain a warrant for his arrest. On the day Shane was killed, the car carrying the accused was stopped by the Garda Drugs Unit. It had no NCT, it wasn't roadworthy. The accused, who was a passenger when the car was stopped, assumed the driver's role in the presence of an Garda, despite not being insured. In the inquest into Shane's death, the court heard that Garda at the scene felt the occupants of the car were in possession of a controlled substance, but the car wasn't searched. Within an hour, Shane was dead. 11 hours later, the accused was arrested. He was released on bail a day later. Garda failed to inform the judge of his convictions or the breaches of his bail conditions. In the aftermath of Shane's death, the accused committed further offences. He served a week in Wheatfield prison for a previous offence. He was also arrested in Belfast on 2 counts of theft. He was eventually tried for motor offences connected to Shane's death and given the option of a custodial sentence or a return to Lithuania. Now, Taoiseach, how could this happen? This is a rural family contributing to the state, looking after their children, minding their neighbours, rearing their children. Now, you may tell me, as the Justice Minister has, that Shane's case is with GSOC, but it's been there for 4.5 years.
Thank you, Deputy
and
Adams.
No result yet. The case Concordia is multi-dimensional, shocking and sickening at every turn. It merits a proper statutory investigation. Taoiseach, will you commit to this, please?
Thank you, Deputy Adams. Taoiseach.
I recall when this accident happened, Deputy Adams, and nothing that I can say or do I will bring back Shane O'Farrell, and I'm happy to see his mother here in the gallery today. I've read the file that you gave me. I've read the other extensive files that exist in this case. I am aware that there is a civic action against the state and that GSOC have been carrying out an investigation on this. I feel that I would like to meet Mrs. O'Farrell and hear her story myself. And I will do so from a humanitarian point of view. There are processes that are always followed. Nothing will bring back Shane O'Farrell, whom I understand was a brilliant young student. So I know the Minister for Justice answered questions on this recently, I think, to Deputy O'Callaghan. And she indicated as she had met the family herself, as indeed many have, that she would like to be in a position to have the response of GSOC, and that that work was well advanced, though, as you point out, has been going on for quite a while. My understanding from that is that GSOC wished to interview a number of other Gardaí, and that the Minister would be prepared to follow through on whatever the recommendations of GSOC were. This is a very sensitive and sad situation for the O'Farrell family. And I'd like to think that at the very least we can do is have every possibility examined so that Mrs. O'Farrell Shane's mother and his sister can be can at least know that the situation was examined in the way that it should be. Thank you for giving me the file which I read and for your question. I'll make arrangements to meet with Mrs. O'Farrell when I have an opportunity.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy Adams.
I thank you, Taoiseach, for your response, and I thank you particularly for agreeing to meet with Mrs. O'Farrell. You know, this was a young lad, as you said. He was 23. He was a brilliant student at Trinity. He was about to start work at the European Parliament. He was a fluent Irish speaker. He was a gentle young man with a bright, bright future. And Lucia and Jim and their family have been robbed of their pride and joy. He was their only son. But this case goes beyond his tragic death. It reveals, in my opinion, a series of grievous flaws in the management and response by the justice agencies. There are 59 complaints with GSOC in relation to Shane's case, but nothing to show 4.5 years later. And this delay is causing ongoing trauma to his family. And I'm sure that you agree that all citizens must have confidence in our justice systems. And of course, all systems have their failings. But we all have a duty to ensure that they are of the very highest standards. As you say, Shane O'Farrell can't be brought back, but his family can get justice. So I thank you for your reply. I thank you for your agreement, as I've said, to meet with Shane's mother. But Taoiseach, they have asked for a statutory inquiry. Will you agree to that? Or failing that today, will you agree to make your position known on this issue after you've met with Mrs. O'Farrell? And can you do that as quickly as your busy schedule would allow?
Thank you, Deputy Adams. Taoiseach.
Yes, I will make my views known. And I will arrange to meet Mrs. O'Farrell as soon as I have an opportunity. I would say that this is one of over 200 cases where people feel very grievously hurt on a range, a very broad range of issues across many years. A review panel was set up to look at all of these cases, including the tragic death of Shane. And that consisted of 2 senior and 5 junior counsel who were very experienced. And the recommendation that they made was to take no further action. Now, I'm not a senior counsel, but my job in politics engages me with so many people. I read this file, and I will meet Mrs. O'Farrell, and I will make my views known. I'd like to think that the GSOC inquiry is, you know, practically complete. That's my understanding. But that's not of any value to people who say, I've been waiting for so long without any clarity as to when I'm going to have a completed document. The Minister of Justice did say, I'd like to get that, and I'd like to decide what the best option is arising from that report. I have no input, obviously, into the civic action. That's a person's right to take a case against the state. But I will meet Mrs. O'Farrell because I want to meet her on a humanitarian basis. This is one of a number of very tragic cases, and as I say, nothing will bring back Shane O'Farrell.
So all right, thank you, Taoiseach.